This is the clock upon the wall. This is the story of us all. This is the first sound of a newborn child before he starts to crawl. This is the wall that's never won.
It happened last year. I was having a quiet beer down at Wentworth Park with a couple of mates, and I looked around and I thought, I need to get this. I need to capture this. It's an incredible subculture of Australia, and I haven't seen anyone do it before. And the more I looked and the more I discovered that there's this infinite resource of incredible Australian, you know, real rugged Australian characters, and I love it. I absolutely love it. I actually had to go through the GBOTA council and all the authorities there, being a gambling facility. You know, it took a couple of proposals and emails and follow-up calls, and actually ending up just going there myself and saying, hey, did you get the emails and the phone calls? In the end, they were very accommodating, and I was able to get access into the actual kennels every week and set up a little mobile studio and just handed out flyers and introduced myself to everyone and just said, look, this is what I'm doing. There's nothing commercial in it for me. It's purely because I find it interesting. And, you know, 9 months later, I'm standing here on the opening of the exhibition, and I'm pretty happy about it. Eight weeks of every Saturday night, myself and Magda, my girlfriend over there, and a couple of assistants and, you know, anyone that was willing to come along on a Saturday night. And, you know, it took a long time to figure out exactly what we were going to do. And then, you know, once we got a rhythm, it was just a case of meeting the same people. And, you know, 1 week they'd come along and be, like, a little reluctant, and the next week they'd be like, all right, I'll do it this week. The exhibition, in my mind, is about the road. It's about music. It's about the journey, you know. These people that come back every week, it's fascinating to just, you know, treat their pride and joy, get them on the track, have a laugh, have a beer. It's a camaraderie. And they do it because they love it. They really love it. And I just love that side of it, that you get this little insight, this little glimpse into their life. This guy over here was there with his wife. He's from Yugoslavia. This guy here had been to Brigadoon earlier that day in Bundanoon. So he travelled up with his girlfriend, and he was walking past and he had a kilt on. And I thought, a kilt at the dog races. Now I need to meet this guy. Yeah. This dog was a prize dog, and it came third, and he just had this incredible look. He was pissed off. You could tell he knew that he'd only come third and he wanted to do better. It was really just a once. I mean, for me, the whole exhibition had to be about that moment that this person's come off the track and they've got something going through their head. Either they've won or lost, their dog's injured, you know, didn't have a good night or had a great night. It was all about getting them once, and whatever I got was to be the shot. Yeah. Yep. Jacob? Yeah, lovely kid. He's he's coming tonight. Yeah. He'll be coming with his mum. I think he's around 10 years old. He's fantastic. But he's a trainer. He has his own dog, and he comes every week. Yeah. And his mum supervises him and makes sure he's all fine. And, you know, he's 10 years old and into it. And he's got this old soul in those eyes. He's got stories to tell already. It's all about the eye contact. And dogs, after they've raced or at any time, they don't want to look at you. I mean, I'm a guy with a camera. I'm not a guy holding a bone.
Yeah.
So it took a long time. I actually had to use a different camera with a faster shutter speed, faster autofocus for the dogs, for that reason. And the important thing is to just create an environment where they're relaxed, and then you just all of a sudden get their attention. Bam. And you only get one chance. Yeah. One chance per dog, and that's it. Once they've done it, they think, that's it. I know what it's like to have my photo taken, and that's it.
Have you got a favourite one?
Yeah, that'd be Earl. He's the granddaddy. He, as soon as I lay my eyes on that guy, he just had a story. Well, a lot of people were scared by him, but he's a gentle giant and lovely bloke. Just a lovely bloke. And he came with his grandson, who's also on. They're all limited editions, so there's only 5 per shot.
Okay.
And they're all one size. And yeah, because they're beautiful archival prints. In a couple of weeks, they'll all be available on my website. Okay. So if people wanted to buy prints.